Mother Dominique come. Dominique rescues cats.
Beautiful. So you're going to write down rescues cats. I usually, did I put a hyphen? This is the devil is in the details. I do that. You don't have to.
Count to eight, right? Count to eight as you're going across. Okay.
Thank you, Jadine. Exactly. Big deal.
Count to eight. Okay.
O'Pakele.
O'Pakele.
O'Dominique.
O'Dominique.
Ika'po'poki.
Ika'po'poki.
O'Pakele. O'Pakele. O'Pakele.
O'Pakele.
O'Pakele.
O'Pakele.
O'Pakele. O'Dominique.
O'Dominique.
Ika'po'poki.
Ika'po'poki.
Okay. Hi, O'Pakele. 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 O'Dominique.
Ika'po'poki.
Ika'po'poki. Ika'po'poki. Ika'po'poki. Ika'po'poki. O'Pakele. O'Pakele. O'Dominique. Ika'po'poki. Ika'po'poki.
Ika'po'poki.
O'Pakele. O'Pakele. O'Jadine. Ika'po'poki. O'Pakele. A'ole. 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 O'Pakele.
O'Pakele.
O'Pakele. O'Dominique.
Ika'po'poki.
O'Pakele.
O'Pakele.
O'Pakele. O'Dominique Ika'po'poki. Aye, a'ole. Aye, aye, aye. Maikai, good, good job. Aye. O'Pakele.
O'Pakele.
O'Dominique.
Ika'po'poki.
Ika'po'poki. Ika'po'poki.
Ika'po'poki.
O'Pakele.
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 O'Vai. O'Vai. Ika'po'poki.
Dominique.
Dominique.
Aye, aye. O'Pakele.
O'Pakele.
O'Pakele. O'Dominique.
O'Dominique.
Ika'po'poki. Aye, aye.
Guys, how can we remember that O'Vai means who?
Because he has it in English right there.
I should have write it down.
Right.
No, yeah, because you got the English. What else could, is there any gesture? I'm just being you. Is there any, and I'm only making suggestions. How can you remember? Is there some kind of gesture memory like we did for basketball? We did a gesture, or is there some sound? Kekeha asks the class, and Ben, the student, answers, I know one. When he said ve, I was thinking oy ve. And so whenever oy ve means like wow or whatever, boy. But when I think about it and I hear ve, it makes me think of who. So whenever I hear you say ve, I'm going to think of who, and now you tell me how great that is and what a great student.
Okay, that's a good, really good.
Ben, those are called word associations.
Right.
Really good word association, Ben. Mahalo, mahalo.
Thank you.
Meikai. Yeah, so when I say that, Vai. You can think about that if that'll help you, that oi vei, is that it?
I'm being you again. Yes, Ben. Now that's just for you because other people may have different kinds of associations. And some of the students in this classroom won't make any associations because they haven't really been thinking like that in school. They've been doing a lot of memorization. But this is very creative, and that's a good one, Ben. I think you can, but I'm not making everybody in the class remember that ve means food. You guys get, you get to do what you want in here in terms of how you remember things.
So they have to come up with a hand signal?
They don't have to do anything.
Okay.
All they have to do is listen.
Or just to associate a word with the question word or a sound with the question word?
Exactly. That's, we talked right about that before you got on. But yes, that's exactly what a word association is. And I offered one, again, underline the point, not everybody has to, they don't, nobody has to do anything. That's key in Krashen's research, because he talks about the affective filter and they need to keep it low. Keep going.
Keep going. Okay, he can, Opakele, Opakele,
O
Dominic,
show me. I'm becoming you. Show me cat. Show me cat.
Show me cat. Yeah, show me cat. Show me cat.
Okay. Now say it.
Popoki. Okay. Popoki. Oh, okay. Yeah, oh, okay. Good job. Yeah, okay. I like that. Popoki. Popoki. Okay. Okay. Yeah. Popoki. Show me popoki.
Popoki.
Popoki. Ah. Oh, show me rescue. Hopakele. Hopakele. Oh, how was that? Should I do that, Dominique? Where?
Uh huh.
Oh. What did Dominique do?
Opakele. Oh, hey,
from, when you see something really.
Paipailima. Oh, my God. Paipailima. Paipailima. No, Dominique. Ah, make it Dominique. Ah, paipailima. 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 Ah, my guy. Ah, my guy. Ah, show me hoopakele.
Hoopakele.
Oh, kalamai. Show me hoopakele. Hoopakele. Show me hoopakele. Ah, my guy. My guy. Show me popoki. Popoki. Ah, popoki. Ah, my guy. Hoopakele. Oops. Sorry about that.
While you're fixing that, when the energy wanes, and it will, right now it's at its height, it's when you go to the next QL.
Okay, Higina. Hopakele.
Hopakele.
O Dominic. Ika popoki. Ihea. Ihea.
How can we remember, class? How can we remember that hair means where?
Yeah.
Oh, hair sounds like where?
Yeah. Okay. good observation, Ben. Yeah, Mekai, that's a good way to think about it. Mekai.
In the library.
Yeah, in the library? Ah. Oh.
In the park.
That's a good mahalo for who said library?
Amy L.
Oh, Amy, mahalo. That's a good your grade just went up doing that by giving suggestions. Very good, Mekai.
In the park.
In the park.
Park?
Park. I think we've done that in my other classes already. So that's a good suggestion. That also helps your grade go up.
Damn, the sewer.
The sound of your grade going up. That's also where.
Down the sewer, true story.
In the sewer?
Is that what is? The sewer. Okay. Oh, yeah. Yeah, perfect. I like that. Okay. Okay. Yeah. Ika paipu sua.
Ika paipu
sua. Ika paipu sua. Opakele.
Opakele.
Dominic. Ika popoki. Ika paipu
sua.
Sua. Sua. Sua. Paipu. 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 Paipu.
Cognate. Brooklyn.
Aye.
Brooklyn dialect.
We speak like that in pidgin. We have a kind of like a language we call pidgin Hawai'i Creole English. It's kind of like that too. So it's kind of
Brooklyn, New York dialect. Sua.
Oh yeah. Close dialects. O Pakele, O Dominique, Ika Po Poki, Ika Paipusua.
Ika Paipusua.
Me, show me with me. Me. Mekai. Show me popoki. Popoki. Oh, my guy. Show me hopakele. 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 Mekai. Good. Mekai. Show me me with me. Me.
Dominique.
Me vai. Me vai.
Dominique.
With
her mother.
Dominique.
Her mother.
Opakele.
Opakele.
O Dominique.
Dominique.
Ika popoki. Me.
Dominique.
Me vai.
Dominique. With her mother.
Oh.
Dominique.
Right? With her mother?
He's asking with whom.
Me with. Show me me with. Me. Yes. Oh, my guy. Good job. Me with me. Me vai. Me her mother. That's a good answer, but
not today.
That's a good one, not today.
Everybody, well, I gotta check some suggestion. Mahalo, Ben. Me.
Shaq.
Me vai.
Shaq.
Ay, mahalo, Ben. That's a good one. Ay, me, Shaq. Okay, we're going back. We're going to the next section, which is the review. And then the review. Ho'opakele.
Ho'opakele.
O Dominique. Ika popoki.
Popoki.
Ika paipusua. Okay.
By the way, when you just said, oh, we're going to the review phase. Remember, you just said that? You may want to walk over, just have some kind of poster of the star or something and say, oh, look, kids, we're doing this now. Because when kids who are in a new class who are trained visually,
mm-hmm.
and 93% of the human experience is visual, and with middle school kids, it's probably 99%. Mm-hmm. Then they look at the star that you have on the wall in a physical classroom, and they go, this teacher knows what they're doing.
All right, we have the popoki, Ika popoki. Ika paipusua. Okay. And hopakele o Dominique. Hopakele o Dominique. Ika popoki. My guy. Ika paipusua. Me. Shaq. Oh, mahalo. My guy. Mahalo. Amy, mahalo nui. Okay, now shall we go to the quiz? Is that it?
Okay, you just did the review while she sent it, or whatever.
Right, mahalo, Amy.
And you just did the reveal. Right. So yes, you're on the quiz.
Okay, so now we're gonna have the first quiz for today. Ho'opakele, no, helu ekahi, number one, helu ekahi. Number one, ho'opakele o Dominique ika popoki. Maikai, very good, very good. Helu Elua, number two. Helu Elua, number two. Helu Elua, number two. Ho'opakele o Dominic Ika dog. Helu Ekolu.
Before you ask number three,
oh, yes.
Make sure that the board is visible because we still have we still need the crutch.
Okay.
And so even if when you ask the question, if you point to it, that's okay. Not cheating. That's not cheating in my mind. Okay. Number three.
Helu Ekolu. Number three. Helu Ekolu. Ho'opakele. O Dominic. Ika popoki.
Ika popoki.
Ika beach.
No.
I aole Ika beach. Helu eha. Helu eha. Ho'opakele. Ho'opakele o Dominic. Me kira. Ho'opakele o Dominic. Me kira. I aole.
Aole.
Ho'opakele o Dominic. Me kira.
I noticed that he did too. You didn't answer the question with because he said with kira, but I don't know about you, but I forgot what with was in the Hawaiian language. But he went back and said the same question, but when he did this, then you gave your answer, Ben. Repeating that question was awesome. That was really very intuitive and really good.
You noticed that I didn't.
No, you didn't answer the first time. You were like looking, trying to figure it out. Well, that's how it looked to me. I don't know if that's what you were.
No, that's exactly because you know when I did it, I said, "Oh man, I'm glad he went like that because now I know." Did you see?
I kind of went this because I knew the name was wrong, but I didn't really know what he said. Yeah, and then when he redid the question, then I put it all together. And when I watched you, it helped me understand.
No, that's exactly what happened.
You can open up the chat so that they can only answer to you. And no one else will see it. I don't know if you know this about Zoom, but they can only speak with the teacher in the chat. So they could be typing C or no or whatever your yes or no is. You can save your Zoom file too, and you can go back and see how many got C, how many got no. I mean, it's the same difference taking a paper and looking at them as just scrolling through it on your Zoom. Because at the Zoom chat at the bottom next to the word file, there are three dots and you can save the chat and look at the chat later instead of looking at papers.
We teach mostly in teams, and I was planning on setting up one of those quizzes, and I can't remember the name of the thing. They just pop right into it and take the quiz right there live. So it captures the data. Is it called a form maybe?
A Google form, you mean?
I would do it that way. The quiz questions and put it in a form.
Google
so they
form?
Open the thing right out of Teams. Because then it will also collect what they said.
But then they have to read it. Are they ready to read it? Like, is there a voice option within that form?
No, like they would have Teams open and I would say in the target language, here's question number one.
Oh, so they would only have the answers. Okay, I'm sorry.
So they would, yeah. And then I may or may not give them thumbs up, thumbs down after everybody answered in Teams and move to the next question. Because my building, my administrator's going to chase me around the room with an axe if I've been in trouble before for supplying the correct answer, which I know is cognitively correct, but they have kittens about it, to say the very least. So my move is going to be having to put that stuff in forms first, and then the forms is closed, which happens real fast, right? Now we're all on question two. And I tell you what question was, what one was. So we're still in the window there for correction. And then just make it a really easy grade. Mm-hmm. I mean, the dance with administrators over grades is maddening.
It is. It's maddening. Just
allow me to agree with you. I've done research in the cognitive realm of education, and it's just, but you have to do it. Yeah. So Ben, do you think there's any harm in doing it that way with having them write the yes or no first, and then afterwards we give the correct answer?
Absolutely not.
If you Google Forms, if you just have yes or no on each of the questions as a, you know, it comes in a spreadsheet that you can create a spreadsheet with all the answers. Yeah. And as long as the first question is the kid's first name, last name, and period, then, you know,
Yeah.
You'll have all your data right there.
Yeah.
And you won't even have to print it.
It's up to the accountability, right?
Just shoot out the link to the form to them. And it's all in a spreadsheet, and you can just save it to your drive, and that's it.
Google itself, it makes a spreadsheet automatically.
You can show it in a pie chart. Oh, look how many people got this right. You can show the spreadsheet for your administration.
Automatically analyzes everything for you.
The other important point here is, in order to, you guys are familiar with cognitive load, right? How much is going through the strainer and making it into the pile, right?
Right.
Minimize that by giving the correct answer in a timely manner between my effort, which was maybe I say A and the correct answer is B. I need to hear B within 8 or 10, you know, quickly.
But
I have to capture that A was said. And then next time you're going to know it's A because I corrected you real quickly, right? Your progress is going to be shown. But we can't leave out that part of the quickness of the form opens, you put in your answer, you close it, the teacher sees it's closed and says, and that was B.
Right.
B. Say it a few times, right? So this is my point. You have to look at that as a without
Kara,
that
part, would you have each another, question as a separate
way to fail? How's that?
Does that make sense? Would you evaluate KKH's quiz as successfully meeting the articulated statement you just made?
Did he give, I don't remember if, you did it, Ben, you provided the answer so quickly in relation to, so you said, what's the answer, you know, A, and you said it is A. So my administrator, because I gave the,
you're talking about cognitive load, and you've done all this time, spent
that's
all
right
time on that kind of thing in your administrator.
Well, yeah, he's an administrator anyway. The point is that you can't have them together. They'll argue with you, and I don't care who you are, what credential you have, you have to separate them out. And I think it's a state thing. I don't think it's an ego thing. I think the state makes them do that. So, and cognitively, you don't have to lose the juice there. It just has to be in a timely manner and easy for the kid to access. So that's why I was thinking the forms, but I haven't done it yet. So,
can I ask you, if we were to do it in forms, then if you need to give that feedback right away, would each question be its own form then? That would be a little laborious.
Does the forms go in one direction, like Nearpod, where you can only go forward question one to question two, and it can't go backward?
You can make them required or not required on a Google.
Right. So that's what you're going to do, is set it up so the questions run through five, go one is answered now. Now two is answered. That's it. Three is answered. So they can't go backward.
No, they can't go backward. But what I'm saying is, are we... Maybe I'm overthinking it. Hold on.
You'd have to leave the quiz open. You'd have to open it and have them use it and close it. Yeah. There's all sorts. I think Forms does that, but if it doesn't, I can ask my
software. I'm sure it does, but I just wanted to, because there is a if then kind of thing in Forms. So if they did get the wrong answer, you could actually bring them to a different branch of a question. Picture it like a flowchart, if you will. You don't want that. You just want yes, no.
What I want is something to capture the data point of their first answer, and that's all.
Okay.
And so they don't spend all their time figuring out how to do that rather than having it drift right in the way CI is supposed to act, right? Going right past the blockage there. See what I'm saying?
Yes, no. And Ben, as far as it's like 4 or 5 questions, right? The quiz.
Well, that's up to you, but
it wouldn't be more than that. But they could be yes, no, and they could be like the person's name or place, correct?